Say I'll make you shy.
Hello, my YouTube familia. Welcome back. Happy to be here. I have something fun I want to film today. As you all know, or some of you may know, that I have an obsession with powders. I don't know why, because I am normal to dry, which is interesting, but I do love powders. I mess with them all. Powder foundation, setting powders, finishing powders. I love to try them all. And I do particularly have an obsession with pink powders for my under eye. I just feel like it's very flattering on my skin tone. And it just gives this nice brightening, softening look to your under eye. So who doesn't want that? But when I saw Kylie Cosmetics come out with one, KKW has one, and I feel like they've kind of like honed in on that market of that like pink baking powder, which is awesome. So I thought it'd be fun to see how the two differ with each other. And with that being said, I am not partial. I do like products from both lines, so this is completely unbiased. But I plan on doing it all day, wear test, photo, flash, how it applies, all the goods. So if you wanna see this little experiment, then keep on watching. So really quickly, I will put up some claims on the screen, a price, how much you get for, you know, per gram, all that good stuff, so you can kind of weigh the value of the product. Really quickly too, we can talk about the packaging. So this is what Kylie's powder looks like. This is what KKW's powder looks like. Obviously, I mean, to me, the KKW packaging is just adorable. Okay, I love it. It's so beautiful. I feel like so much time went into it. This is definitely unique packaging. Kylie, I mean, it's pretty self-explanatory. It's pretty basic, but you do get more product for the price. So you could kind of weigh those options out yourself to see, and then we'll also see the formula. Because for me, if I like the product more than the packaging, then obviously I'm gonna go for the product. But just out the gates, I do like KKW's packaging better. And formula, I will put some swatches up of what they look like just swatched. They do both feel super velvety. They feel really nice. The, which one is it? Kylie's actually looks a little bit more pink, and KKW's looks a little more like a really light white pale pink. So I will put that on the screen for you guys, and then we'll see how it actually applies on my skin. So now let's just see how this stuff applies. All right, so as far as the application goes, I do have a disclaimer. When I am doing any type of baking, I am going like full beat, full glam, like full cake face, but not really. But no, I really am going all out with my makeup. There is no in between for me. I'm either looking homeless or I'm full glam. So just so you know, I am using a lot of makeup. So, but I feel like most people that like baking are into a lot of makeup. So, but just so you all know, when we get into this, I am using a lot of makeup. But with that being said, I am extremely picky and extremely critical on looking dry, crepey, like I cannot stand that. So I'm extremely picky with how I do everything and the way I have been doing it. I am obsessed with my under eye application, how it all comes out. So we'll get into that, and I'll show you how I'm going to bake with the technique that I use. So let's start. So first things first, I always moisturize out the shower. I use my Ole Henriksen, I believe it's like the banana brightening cream. So I always use that first. And then another hack, if you do happen to have dry under eye, I know it sounds really weird. I was kind of like scared to try it, but I think it works, is you can use the most tiniest bit of coconut oil on under your eye. What I do is I use a contact case, and it looks like this. I just put like a little dollop in there. And while it's still hard, I'll just like moisten it up a little bit. So you start to feel like the coconut oil residue on your finger. And I will just go in like where I get more dry, or if I feel like the areas where my powder might kind of like kick up. And for me, it's usually like right there. And then like right here. Like, you know, when you smile, you can get like those smile lines. So I just really try to prep and get this area ready. Okay, so the eyes are prepped, and I do kind of limit how much foundation I put under my eye. I try to keep a lot of my under eye bare. So it'll help with, because I do go in with multiple products under my eyes, so it just kind of helps eliminate one less product under my eye. But I do go in first with my NARS Soft Matte, what is it? The Soft Matte Complete Concealer. I love this stuff. I was kind of hesitant to, try it, but I'm in the shade Creme Brulee. I do go for a brighter under eye look, so bear that in mind. But it is the most natural, skin-like, moisturizing concealer. It's awesome. But so you can use your finger. I like to use this just to conceal my under eye like dark circles. And yeah, it helps brighten, but I mainly am doing it to like conceal my my little freckles and my dark circles. All right, now my next concealer I'm gonna be using, yes, another concealer. This is the Too Faced Born This Way. This one works really, really good with the NARS Soft Matte, and this is in the shade Vanilla. I like to use this. It just adds more coverage and more brightening, and I just really like the finish that it gives together. It's like a little concealer cocktail. So I just put a little bit, but to some people that might be a lot, but. So I just do a few little dabs of that, and then I go in with my Morphe E8, and then I just blend that all in. Alrighty. Take a sip.
43 minutes of film left.
Ruby, go on. Okay, so I'm good with the coverage I've got. I'm happy now with, you know, I had to... What's that girl doing? You're not gonna get any treats, Rubes.
Go on your bed.
Go on your bed. Thank you. Okay, so now that the concealer is all set, we're gonna set it. Now, what I've been doing, and I actually got the idea from It's Sabrina here on YouTube. She raves about this for her under eye setting, and I finally was like, fine, I'm gonna try it. And I'm glad I did, because I love it. It's the Bare Minerals Bare Pro Performance Wear Powder Foundation, and it's in the shade Dawn 02. And it's a beautiful powder. It's very natural looking. Even though it is a powder foundation, it does obviously give you a little bit more coverage under your under eye, which I like, but it's not cakey, and it's not a dry powder at all. So I love it. And the reason why I'm doing this and I'm not going straight in with the baking powder is because I've seen it a lot on watching other makeup artists do it, but and just from my own personal experience, what I've noticed, when I do go in with baking powder straight away, I do feel like it makes my under eye look extremely dry, and that's obviously not the look I'm going for. And so I find that when you're using some type of other setting powder, it helps create a barrier for the baking. So the baking powders aren't able to get into all those little crevices and fine lines, which would make you look older and drier. So I find that this is what kind of helps set up the canvas for the bake, and then the bake could go in and do all the fun stuff, and that's brighten, smooth, and help with your pores and all that. So I find that this has been helping me with being able to bake. Now, when I'm baking, I like to use most of the time a dry sponge or a wedge. I do use a wet sponge or beauty blender once in a while, but depending on the baking powder, I notice that sometimes they could kind of make your under eye feel really tight, and I hate that feeling. And so it just makes you look more crepey and dry. So depending on the powder, I could get away with just a dry wedge, and you get the same effect, but you don't feel that tightening. So I will go in with the I'll do KKW on my right, and I'll do Kylie on my left. So I'm just gonna go in with the goods. And sometimes I'll just focus it on the inner part of my eye, but for the sake of the video, I'll go in the whole under eye. And I'll do my chin with KKW. And I'll go in with a separate wedge, a clean wedge, and then I'm gonna go in with Kylie's. So you could definitely already see the color difference. Now, I don't like to bake for a long time because I'm more normal to dry skin type, so I'm just gonna go ahead and just dust that off. And when I am baking and doing all these steps, I use a ton of setting powders throughout my whole makeup application process. With bronzers and blushes and highlighters, I'll probably use like setting powder or setting sprays like 5 times. So that does also help cut back on like the dryness and the powdery look. So, oh my God, you're being such a needy girl. So straight off the bat, let's take a look-sees. Okay, so right now, I feel like Kylie or Kim's definitely, I'm thinking, looks brighter. They both look kind of, I feel like KKW's might look a little drier. Pores look good. I want to say Kylie's might look a little better. But let me get into, I'm gonna do my setting spray magic and I'm gonna go ahead and apply the rest of my makeup and we'll see how this all comes together. And yeah, so I'll be right back. Okay, so makeup's all done, so I'm feeling a little bit more human. But let's see, what time is it? It's almost 9 a.m. Let's see. It's almost 9. So I'm going to get some really good wear time out of these powders and I'm gonna see how they hold up on me. Just looking at everything again, they do look super similar, I'm not gonna lie. You guys tell me if you notice a difference on which side up close. So far, I think I am liking Kylie's side a little more. It's just looking super smooth, like no texture. I'm noticing like a little bit more texture on this side of my face, but maybe that's just my side of my face too. But I will keep you guys posted. I will try to hit you guys with some pics with flash. I will try to even get some natural light. I'm gonna try to get some selfies. I'm not a big selfie kind of person, but I will try to get some for you guys so you can see in a natural light. And yeah, so that's it. So I will see you guys later on. Okay, so I'm back. It's 5:23. It's been almost 8.5 hours. I'm ready. I got the hoodie on, hair in a bun, ready to take this face off. So are you ready? The product that I picked was, I picked Kylie's pink powder. She won. I really like Kylie's powder. How I will say, I do really like KKW's powder. They are super similar. I will give you that they are very, very similar. But on my skin tone anyways, and my skin, I noticed that Kylie's powder blurred out my skin more. You really couldn't see any texture under my eye. And I think that with it being a more of a pinker hue, it did, I feel, cover the darkness and disguise it better under my eye. As far as the KKW, I did see more texture right here, like under my eye, and I do feel like I could see more of the darkness under my eye. So, you know, I mean, if that's what it's gonna come down to, and then also putting into consideration the price, how much you get, the value, for me, I would have to go with Kylie's powder for the value, for the formula, all the good stuff. I give it to Kylie, so. But I do have a one, whatchamacallit, little what do you call it? I don't know what I'm trying to say. I'm tired. But I did want to give a shout out to KKW Beauty for their brightening powder. If you haven't tried it, it's really, really good. I have it in, shocker, the pink shade, number two, the brightening, and I love this powder. It's great if you are looking for a little more extra pop of brightening in the under eye. So I am really excited. I didn't try it today because I just wanted to try the baking powders, but I'm really excited to use this with the Kylie pink powder instead of the KKW powder. So that's gonna be something fun to try. I don't see why they wouldn't look good together if I already love both of them, but you never know, but I'm excited. But yeah, so I think that's it. I hope I covered everything. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I'll see you on the next one.